you're in the world's first commercial rooftop greenhouse. We built this farm in 2010, 2011. It's one out of three farms we have in Montreal that are working to feed close to 2% of the population of the city. My partner, Lauren, was a biochemist studying at McGill University, and I had a software company, and we just wanted to get into agriculture. We loved agriculture, we loved technology, and we loved world-changing ideas. So you'll be getting a phenomenal visit today by Simon, who manages our community for Lufa Farms. Enjoy.
So our lights are on right now because it's an overcast day. Generally speaking, we try to keep them off as much as we possibly can. If there's sun, that's what we'll use. That's what the plants love. When it comes to keeping them on all night, a lot of people ask about that. We don't do that. We try to give the plant a natural life cycle. Healthier for the plant, healthier for the vegetable you get at the other end. And it saves on energy, of course.
So it's hydroponics. So essentially all the plants you see here are grown in an inert substrate. We actually use coconut fiber because it's very lightweight and it's great for oxygenation. And a good percentage of the water in this greenhouse comes from snow and rain that we collect on the roof of the farm. The way it works is we have these concentrations of vitamins or concentrated Gatorade, and we've got our irrigation water. And once a week, we send our water to a lab, and the lab tells us exactly what the plants took out of the water. And we're able to simply add back the nutrients that the plants took up. So this allows us to recirculate our water indefinitely, but it also allows us to ensure that the plants at all times have what they need from a nutrient perspective. So all the calcium, potassium, sulfates, and nitrates are all added in the water, and we monitor them on a weekly basis. We also use about half the energy to heat our greenhouse than a farm on the ground, and that's because we're on top of a building that's heated. So in a city like Montreal, where it's a very cold city, you've got all these buildings burning fossil fuels to heat, and then a lot of the heat escapes through the roof. Well, we capture all that heat and use it to heat the greenhouse. And that gives us a much warmer platform to grow our foods. And we insulate the building by covering almost the entire building and creating a much lower heat transfer between the tenants below and the outside. So you'll find insects in our farm a little bit everywhere. We actually introduce beneficial insects that go out and attack the bad insects. When it works really well, you actually have a very low population of both, and the plants are just left alone. We also have a big composter in the basement, so all the leaves that we remove every single week are sent down, they're composted, and they're turned into a compost that we then sell to on the marketplace to our lufavores. It's just another way of closing the cycle. What's really unique about this farm is we harvest only what's sold. So all the cucumber you guys see here, they still have the little flower on, get harvested every single morning, and they're usually at our consumers' homes the same day, just hours later. What that means is it means we have zero waste in this farm. We're only harvesting what was sold, so the plants act as our fridge in our warehouse, and the freshness and the quality is just unbeatable.
So the new Anjou greenhouse has over 63,000 square feet of growing space. Right now, we have approximately 40 varieties of greens and vegetables growing in this greenhouse. So these are the vertical propagation tables here in Anjou. So every single plant that grows in the Anjou greenhouse starts its life in one of these beds. We call them vertical propagation tables for obvious reasons. They're stacked on top of each other. And that gives us the opportunity to save a lot of room when we're seeding. And you'll notice that the light is pink. That's actually an optical illusion. There are blue lights and red lights giving the illusion of pink. The reason the light is pink and blue like that is it gives the plant everything it needs without creating any heat. And if you're wondering, the little blocks in which the seeds are growing are made of coconut husk. Instead of using soil and wasting a resource, we actually use the waste material from another industry to grow our vegetables. So these don't really give the plants any nutrients as such. It just gives the roots a place to root and for the plant to stay up once it starts growing. But the actual nutrients come from the diluted mineral salts in the water. Now these beds you're looking at right now are watered from the bottom. So at precise moments throughout the day, the water level will come out from underneath the table, wet the roots, and just drop back down until the next cycle comes up. One of our goals at Lufa Farms was to create a polyculture environment, meaning that we grow many types of vegetables under one roof, which isn't really the norm in the greenhouses. So once the seedlings have spent enough time in the vertical propagation tables and they're, you know, big enough to actually be planted, this is where they come. These are the actual hydroponic growing channels, and the little coconut cubes we were looking at earlier are set into the channels. As you'll notice, is that right now the channels are just tucked one right against each other. Because the plants are really small, they don't need any room at this point. When they harvest, they push a button, it moves the whole row down so they can harvest one row, two rows, three rows, and these just keep going that way. And we can keep adding rows at this end. So the plants start their life here, and as they move down, of course, they get bigger. And as they get bigger, the channels separate themselves. Basically, it permits us to grow a lot more stuff with less square footage. When the harvesters finish harvesting at the other end, they take the channels, put them on here. This thing travels all the way back to this side so they can reuse the empty channels to plant at this end. So these drip systems were developed by one of our founders, by Lauren Rathmel. So the water comes out through these tubings. The water would go right into the growing channels, water the plant right from the roots, and drip into a channel like this one. The system's 100% self-contained, so we hardly lose any water except through evaporation. We don't lose our nutrients, and we don't waste anything and never put anything back out into the sewer. As soon as the sensors sense that the greenhouse is too cold, too warm, too wet, not ventilated enough, things kick in on their own. On very, very sunny days when it gets warm in here, as we walk around, sometimes we hear the windows open on their own. Ventilation systems go on, off, all on their own. Drip systems also, watering systems for the channels. Everything is calculated by software. So on a day like today, overcast, no sun, quite cold outside, we have no choice but to have the heaters on. To keep this place cool in the summer when it gets incredibly hot in here, this wall of cardboard is kept wet and there are vents behind it. These fans suck the air through the vents behind this cardboard. And as the water goes through the cardboard, through the wet cardboard, there's a heat exchange that happens, and this is what keeps the place cool in the summer. We usually try to make things available that are not available in Montreal, generally speaking. We had lufavores who were asking for shiso, which is a Japanese herb, which is quite hard to find around here. Even Asian markets don't often have them. We tried it out. It grows incredibly well. It's really, really tasty. Another vegetable we decided to try out, and we weren't quite sure it would work, but it does, is the kohlrabi. It has a texture of somewhere between a radish and a rutabaga. You can eat the leaves, they're just like cabbage leaves. As you can see, some of them are flowering, so that's part of our challenges with some of our varieties when they get to this end. This is something we're working on solving right now. A lot of the vegetables we find in grocery stores were grown principally because they're durable and they can survive that trip from wherever they come from. What we do here, because we harvest fresh daily and our vegetables don't have to travel, well, what we can do is select varieties and cultivars for their taste instead of for their durability. So in 2013, when we opened our second greenhouse in Laval, we also launched the online marketplace, which is basically an online farmer's market where you can order over 1,500 different products from over 200 different local producers and ourselves. But basically, when you wrap up your order at 12 o'clock at night, we send the orders to our partners. Our partners bake, cut your meat, we pick your vegetables fresh, and they end up here in the distribution center in the morning. And this is where all the baskets are customized before they're sent along to the lufavores.
Is when we started the company, we had absolutely no idea how to grow food. We had never grown a tomato nor sold a tomato in our lives. In our first week, we had about 200 families that were getting a Lufa basket. And just last week, we broke the 10,000 ship basket record. So we're quite excited. We feel that more and more citizens are asking for local, fresh, responsible foods. And we feel that, what we're doing today is potentially game-changing and is a great way to feed people in cities all over the world. So thanks for watching. If you guys want more information, Google us, Lufa Farms. Visit our website, montreal.lufa.com. We also have a Facebook page, an Instagram account, Twitter feed, and a Flickr page. And you can always email us. We always reply to anyone with any questions. So thanks.